Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to Amber Enterprises India Limited Q1 FY22 earnings conference call. This conference call may contain forward-looking statements about the company, which are based on the beliefs, opinions, and expectations of the company as on date of this call. These statements are not the guarantees of future performance and involve risks and uncertainties that are difficult to predict. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touch-tone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Jasbir Singh, Chairman and CEO from Amber Enterprises. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Hello and good morning, everyone. First and foremost, I hope you all are keeping safe and healthy. On the call, I'm joined by Mr. Daljit Singh, Managing Director, Mr. Sudhir Goyal, CFO, Mr. Sanjay Arora, CEO, Electronics Division, Mr. Sachin Gupta, CEO, Room AC Division, and SGA, our Investor Relations Advisors. We have uploaded our result presentation on the exchanges, and I hope everybody had an opportunity to go through the same. I would open my remarks by giving a brief overview on the industry environment, followed by business update and operational and financial performance highlights for Q1 FY22. Consumer durable industry saw a soft first quarter, with sales taking a hit amid the second wave of the pandemic that led to regional lockdowns. However, the impact was less severe compared to the last year ago, which saw a stringent nationwide lockdown. With a renewed national focus on strengthening the healthcare infrastructure and an accelerating vaccination drive, we expect industry prospects to be positive. As we speak today, demand recovery across the sector has been faster than expected. However, the quarterly sales were disrupted due to lower offtake during last 10 days of April, May, and June, which was our peak season. On the channel inventory side, there has not been much inventory in channel due to less severe lockdown compared to last year and ban on import of refrigerant filled ACs. As we speak today, channel inventory is at comfortable levels. The long-term positives for the industry and our company continues to be the following. First is PLI scheme. We believe the additional manufacturing capacity coming under the PLI scheme would have huge multiplier effect and help build a robust supply chain networks for the AC industry. The main objective of government for this scheme is to develop component ecosystem in India and increase domestic value addition in components from 25% currently to 75% in next five to six years. This is going to be very big game changer for the component ecosystem. At Amber, we are all set to leverage on this opportunity. We believe this opportunity will further strengthen our presence in the domestic market and create a solid foothold for exports market. Second is import ban on refrigerant filled ACs. As mentioned previously, the ban on imports with refrigerant filled ACs has opened opportunities for the domestic manufacturers. With this notification, OEMs can partner with us for outsourcing for room ACs. Over here, we have already signed six new customers since the notification has been announced. We believe with the government support, along with stay at home and work from home becoming a new normal, there is a greater acknowledgement of the role played by home appliances in the life of the consumer. This, combined with low penetration levels, improving infrastructure, and an upwardly mobile middle class, will lead to sustained growth over next few years. On the export side, presently, we are in discussion with large brands in two export markets, Middle East and U.S. In the Middle East market, the approval process is completed, and we have started exporting components and room air conditioners. For the U.S. markets, approval process is on track, and we expect the approvals by next financial year. We are continuously investing in R&D for new product developments and better energy efficient products. We will be future ready with the product portfolio to cater to the increasing demand across segments. I will now take you through the consolidated financial highlights. On the revenue side, our consolidated revenue for Q1 FY22 stood at rupees 708 crores as against rupees 259 crores in Q1 FY21. For the quarter, room AC contributed 64% of the total revenues, while components and mobility application contributed 36% of the revenues. On operating EBITDA side, for Q1 FY22, operating EBITDA stood at rupees 50 crores as against a loss of rupees 3 crores in Q1 FY21. Q1 FY22 operating EBITDA does not include ESOP expense of rupees 3.26 crores. Operating EBITDA margins for Q1 FY22 stood at 7%. PAT for the quarter stood at rupees 11 crores as compared to a loss of 24 crores in Q1 FY21. PAT margins for Q1 FY22 stood at 1.6%. Now coming to subsidiary financials. On the Sidwal, Q1 FY22 revenues for Sidwal stood at 50 crores, operating EBITDA stood at rupees 12 crores, and margins stood at 24.6%. With the increased focus of government for comfortable travel and high-speed movement, we believe the sector has an exciting journey ahead. We continue to remain confident to deliver and maintain healthy order book going ahead. We are also progressing well with the new product developments like dumper air conditioners for mining machine used in defense, electric AC for electric buses, AC for harvester combines for agriculture applications, and metro AC for different climate conditions in India for Mumbai Metro, Delhi Metro, and Bangalore Metro. Sidwal order book stands healthy today at more than 425 crores. PICL, our motor division, revenues for PICL stood at rupees 36 crores for Q1 FY22, operating EBITDA 3 crores and operating EBITDA margin 9%. As per the industry data, currently 70% of the BLDC motors is imported. At PICL, we would like to capitalize on this opportunity, and we have already done the R&D and required CAPEX for BLDC, and work has also started. Our endeavor is to provide solutions for both captive users and our export customers. We are already in advanced stages with few large size OEMs on this product. Our electronic subsidiaries, Iljin and Ever. For Q1 FY22, revenue for Iljin stood at rupees 43 crores and Ever revenue at 18 crores. Q1 FY22, Iljin saw an operating loss of rupees 1.7 crores and operating EBITDA forever stood at 0.15 crores. As the market is moving rapidly towards inverter ACs, we are confident of growing our revenue share from Iljin and Ever going forward. With the help of our in-house developed inverter PCB boards for room ACs sector, we've added 5 new customers in Iljin and few more customers are in process of approval. To conclude, I would like to reiterate that our constant endeavor would be to increase penetration and increase our wallet share in the existing customers, continuously adding new customers, create a foothold in the export markets, and enhance our products with a new technology by focusing on R&D. With this, I open the floor for discussion.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and 1 on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and 2. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We would like to remind participants that you may press star 1 to ask a question. The first question is from the line of Ravi Swaminathan from Spark Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Good morning. My first question is with respect to the industry growth this year. What kind of growth that we can expect in terms of volumes in the industry this year compared to last year, if you can throw some light. My second question is with respect to the BE norm change that is coming in 2022. So how is it likely to affect the ratings and pricing of products?
Good morning, Ravi. Industry growth, it was good in quarter four, where we saw almost about 20%. But then since, you know, from middle of April, some areas of India got affected and then lockdown started. So last year, industry ended up doing, now since the data is out on the numbers, it's the real number which has come out is about 5.2 million against the 7 million mark of 1920. I expect, despite of the quarter one, I would say soft performance due to partial lockdowns, industry should be somewhere, should end up somewhere in our estimates near to about 6 or 6.2, but not to a 7 million mark. But it again depends on how quarter four will pan out to be. Let's see. July was very positive for the industry. Almost every customers and every brand witnessed a very good growth in July month, which was a completely, you know, there was no lockdown in the country. And on the BE part, yes, 1st of January 2022 is when the new energy table is revised. So we are already geared up as Amber with all the product portfolio. We are ready to serve with the new rating. It will enhance some bit of costing on the product side to a tune of about 700 to 1200 rupees range, depending on model to model. But I think we have seen in past also that any energy table has not dissuaded the sales of the industry. Rather, you know, people have started going for a more energy efficient category air conditioners. So we expect the same post the implementation of the new energy table.
Got it, sir. My next question is with respect to the margins. I mean, the gross margins we have maintained in spite of input cost increase. So how have you managed it? Have we completed taking price increases to our customers?
Yeah, Ravi, we have a, you know, quarterly lag mechanism on price increases or decreases, you know, with our customers. We cannot go to them on a daily basis or maybe a monthly basis. It's very difficult. So that's industry norm from last about three decades that every quarter price gets revised. So we've been able to pass on all the impacts of the currency and commodity both to our customers successfully in all. There was some lag in Ilgin and Ever, where we introduced new customers in the month of April, which could not be passed on, which will be passed on by next quarter. Otherwise, we have been very successful in passing on all the currency and commodity exchanges.
Got it, sir. And my final question is with respect to the PLI and CapEx plan. Your views on Amber's subscription to the PLI scheme and the CapEx plan for this year and next year?
Sure. So on PLI, first of all, I'm glad to share that, you know, our new greenfield facilities, which we actually announced last year before the PLI was announced, that is getting covered in the PLI. We are eligible for that. And both the greenfield facilities will be covered in that. And we are applying from our subsidiaries as well as for Amber in two categories. In the higher topmost categories with the 300 crore investment in a normal investment category. And then we are also applying for our motor subsidiary in the lower intermediary side in a range of 50 to 100 crore. So total about 400 crore investments application will go from Amber side.
This is over for the PLI alone, sir, so this 400 crore?
Yeah, actually, you see, we are already investing in the greenfield facilities. So our that is getting covered, and the only additional will be the PICL, which will be investment will come in next 5 years. So you know, almost about 100 crore will be invested in next 5 years in the motor division.
Got it. And CAPEX for this year and next year, sir, how much will it be?
So CAPEX, because our greenfield facilities are, will be, one of them will be up and running this year, and the next one is in making. So we expect the, plus the maintenance CAPEX and R&D, everything including, we should be in the range of, on the console I'm talking, including the subsidiary CAPEX, we should be in the range of about 350 crores, and, near about.
Got it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Participants who ask a question, you may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Dhruv Jain from Ambit Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi sir, good morning. Sir, I had two questions. One question was with respect to the PCB subsidiaries. So, you know, we saw that in the last three or four quarters, the PCB subsidiaries have not been doing as well as the other part of the portfolio. So just wanted your thoughts on that and how do you see that, you know, playing over the next two or three years?
Well, we have Sanjayji here. I think Sanjayji, would you like to answer this?
Yeah. So, sir, the situation is that, okay, we started this year with a very positive sign of expecting to, you know, target about 35 to 40% growth in the PCB segment. But unfortunately, again, by the third week of April, we went into the second wave and all our plans actually went very haywire. And not only that, we could not do whatever we wanted to do in the quarter one because there was whole lot of confusion. You know, the industry would open for a week, then again close the customers of ours. So that was one thing. Asking for the past few quarters, since last November onwards, the, you know, there has been a big shortage in the chip components. There has been a lot of price increase. There has been freight cost increases and many such things which could not really, you know, did not support us to achieve our expected results, though we were planning much better results than what actually came forward to. So at the same time, we are also trying to, you know, enter into, come out of just consumer durable PCB makers. We want to enter into other areas like electrical fans, then in the entertainment side, speakers, wearables, smart switches, and OTT devices. So once we enter into all these areas, we hope that the PCB business will be much better than what we have performed up to now.
Thank you, sir. And sir, my second question was with respect to the PLI. So you mentioned that you would be investing about 300 crores from Amber, right? So what kind of components will be covered, right? So it's going to be, you know, what kind of components and will, you know, sub-assemblies of ACs also qualify there? And what is the revenue that you are kind of expecting from that?
So component, there are almost about 9 components which have been covered in PLI, which are sheet metal, injection molding, then heat exchangers, motors, PCB boards. These are the 5 components which Amber will be applying. And also cross flow fan, 6 components. Then copper, tube, aluminium, and compressors. These are 3 and service valves. So in total, about 10 components have been categorized by government for PLI, out of which Amber will be applying for 6 categories.
And so you think you'll be able to meet the ceiling?
We will be able to meet what?
The meet the ceiling requirements of the PLI scheme.
Yes. We are eligible for that.
And sir, just one last bookkeeping question. If you could just give the RAC volume data for this quarter. Thanks.
So in RAC, we have done 478,000 units this quarter.
All right. Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you. Reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one at this time. The next question is from the line of Abhishek Ghosh from DSP Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, sir. Thank you so much for the opportunity. Sir, if you can just help us understand the business opportunity which is kind of coming through because of the whole non-tariff barrier which was imposed. in the last year of October, what is the kind of business opportunity that is kind of coming out of that restriction?
Good morning, Abhishek. For the the import ban which was actually levied the last year in month of last week of September, we have seen a very positive data of imports going down from the period of October till March. Almost about 85% of import reductions have been seen. So as commented in my commentary that almost we have added six customers with which we started in phase one gas charging facilities, and now they are out of six, four have been converted into manufacturing customers where we'll be starting supplies as a ODM with them and OEM with them from the month of December. And with two customers, we'll be starting from January or February. So that is we see an increase in volume by next financial year, almost about 800,000 numbers should be added because of these new customers by next financial year.
Okay. And do you believe that a lot of the customers are also putting up shops, or because I think the total import size is about 1.8 to 2 million. So you're saying 40% of that you'll be able to capture. So is it going to the rest of the contract manufacturers, or is it people are also putting up shop for producing their or manufacturing their own units?
So basically about 15 to 20% still continues to be imported. And if we reduce that, out of that, almost 50% has come to us. And remaining companies like Havells and some other companies who had their own facilities, so they have started in-house. And anybody, we haven't heard apart from them, anybody putting up a new facilities. But in case somebody puts up a new facilities and do not wish to go for outsourcing, we will be happy to serve components to them because they will be needing components for their assemblies.
And so the loss in Iljin in the current quarter, this is more to do with the commentary that you mentioned that the price hikes could not be initiated with the newer customers that you have boarded on, right? That's the way to look at it.
Two factors, yes. One was this factor which you spoke. Second was, as Sanjayji told, that we started this financial year in anticipation of hitting about 35 to 40% growth. And so, our fixed expenses went up, which could not be reduced due to this lockdown period of 2 months' time. That also impacted. But now, I think in next 9 months, you will see a good, decent growth in Iljin Ever.
And sir, all these smaller, relatively smaller motor and, the PCB makers, they would be also in deep trouble because of the overall volatility and the issues which Mr. Sanjayji spoke about. Any thoughts on the overall industry?
Yeah, I think everybody suffered because of the chip shortages and these kind of disruptions. So I haven't seen anybody who's passed on clearly. Most of them have gone through the same cycle.
Okay. And sir, in terms of Sidwal, given the newer opportunities that you're talking about, what is the total addressable market size or opportunity that Sidwal will typically kind of bid for, because it includes railway, metro, dumper? So how should one look at the total addressable annual opportunity size for Sidwal?
Actually, it's volatile right now, the addressable market, because in railways, if we see, only 30% of the coaches being produced in the three factories were air conditioned till last year. Now with the new notification, that has gone up to almost 50%. And number of coaches production is also going up. So if we combine that, plus as our Honorable Minister, I think last week only suggested that almost 1,071 kilometers of metro new lines are being laid out in 27 cities. So combining that plus the other addressable market for Sidwal, it's going to be a good market size. Earlier it used to be in a span of just 600-700 crores, but now it is going to double and triple.
Okay. And sir, just two last questions from my side. We have seen a lot of inflation in the overall AC product itself because of the issues we discussed, plus the whole norm change will further increase. So what is the total increase that one should expect over the last 6 months to 1 year? That would have happened in the overall product of an AC?
Abhishek, total 10-12% impact on finished goods pricing has been passed on to the consumers by all the brands. Some did it in one shot, and most of the brands did it in staggered manner. But the beauty of the market is that despite of 10-12% increase in the product pricing, everybody was positive in Q4, and also in July we have seen a robust growth. So I think markets have very well accepted that 10-12% increase. And plus, as you asked about the BEE impact, which I stated that it will be in a range of about 800-1200 rupees per air conditioner, depending on model to model. As we have seen in past also in the three BEE table change, it has never disrupted the industry by volumes. In fact, consumers have tend to be shifting towards more premium products, which saves more energy.
And just one last question from my side, sir. For the PICL, there's also this change in norm which is coming for fans. So would you also go in for BLDC motors for fans and other things? Because you spoke about for Elgin and Ever, but for PICL also, would you kind of open up that opportunity for you guys?
Yeah, we are doing that. In fact, we did not had BLDC portfolio earlier. Now, I mentioned that in my commentary that we've done the CapEx. We are ready with the product for AC industry. Now we will be diversifying the portfolio in different applications.
Okay. Great. Thank you so much, and wish you all the best. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Abhishek.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Vineet Prasad from Investec. Please go ahead.
Good morning, sir. I have one question. Sir, if we look at what our customers have reported in terms of their Q1 performance, if you look at their segmental capital employed, it appears that these companies, the likes of Voltas, are carrying slightly higher than usual inventory with them. So would that mean that for next quarter or so, volume offtake from Amber could be slightly lower than what it is generally?
No, it's not like that. In fact, we have only four or five players out of 52 brands who are listed in the industry. And if we see about the Japanese players and Koreans and other brands, they are not sitting at that high inventory levels. So overall, our take is that the inventories in overall numbers are less than as it was last year in pandemic. So, and the July has been positive, so inventory is getting liquidated, whatever smaller numbers we have. So it will come to a normalized level by September, October.
Okay. So just one more question regarding the volume numbers which you mentioned. Can you just give a sense how business was or how volumes moved in each of the 3 months, just to indicate how demand is coming back and how much was it of impacted due to the second wave?
I don't have actually month-wise data in hand right now. We'll provide it separately. We'll send it to SGA, which can coordinate with you.
Sir, even if
78 against I think 190,000 last year.
Sir, even quantitative, sorry, qualitative color on this would be helpful. How it moved over the 3 months?
Yeah, April we were growing. I think April we were about 25% up as compared to this. Then the last 10 days got disrupted, but the financial year started with a very good sign, and July has also been very positive.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Naval from Emkay Global Financial Services. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity, sir. Just to check the number, you stated that your volume number this quarter was 478,000. So if I imply your realizations have gone up almost 19% on YOY basis. So can you throw some color on this, product mix, or we have purely product mix, or we also added gas refilling revenues in this? Because earlier it was not. So any color there?
Gas filling is not.
So gas filling volumes have not been added in this. But yes, of course, the revenue has been added in here because that's primarily a job work kind of a thing. It's not a very big revenue which is contributing to the whole 708 crores. But overall, yes, it's been a little bit of a product mix, I would say, because that's not in our hand. We move as per the markets. So some of the high value premium products were sold more. And high RM cost also contributed. So it's a mix and match of couple of factors.
Okay. And second question is on commercial AC. If you can, give incremental, insight there, how we are progressing, any order book update you want to share, some insight there.
I think we started with two products last year. I mean, last quarter four. Where we did about 7-8 crore revenue. This year we are expecting about 45 to 50 crore revenue from CAC, and the product profile is adding. But we have Sachin here on the call. Sachin, would you like to answer? Throw some light here.
Sure. So, sir, as this week we told that CAC, we started with mainly two products. It was under the range of duct cable, and I would say light commercial air conditioners outdoor unit. So now with the regular focus on our R&D and the product lineup expansion, so we are able to add a lot of new products. So the primarily being the cassette series for the indoor side. So if you see today, whatever sells in India, majorly two brands are manufacturing, rest all is imports to our country. So we will be the first ODM in the country to come up with our own design for the cassette series. Apart from this, we will be starting with the ductable range of 8.5 ton and 11 ton. So last year, our prime focus was up to 5.5 ton. So this year with add-on of the cassette series plus add-on of the bigger tonnages of the ductable. So as Jasbirji said that we shall be targeting somewhere around 40 to 50 crores of turnover from CAC.
Got it. Thank you and all the best, sir.
Thank you, Naval.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Madhav Marda from Fidelity International. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Good morning. Thank you so much for your time. I just want to understand on the Middle East exports, you said that we've already started exporting RACs as well. Could you help us with how much volume we have done in the first quarter? And how do we expect volumes to scale up here in the next, FY22 and FY23?
Good morning, Madhav. So it's been a, first, I would say, sales towards Bahrain and other countries. Components are definitely going from last 2 years, but room AC was the first shipments which we did. I think, Sachin, can you throw some light more here on the Middle East markets?
Sure. So, sir, if you see, sir, Middle East, basically, sir, we are divided into two kind of products. So, one is the range of 50 hertz, second is the 60 hertz. So, sir, we started with the 50 hertz of the products, and, the biggest challenge to serve this country is getting the GMARS and CB certification, which we are not able to get in India. So we had to get those certifications from China, which took us almost like 8 to 9 months. So we received our certifications in the month of March this year. And post that, we got the product approval from this market. So the quantities that you are asking for the first quarter, we did somewhere around 2,000 numbers, which includes Bahrain and Dubai, majorly, primarily. And moving ahead, so this year, I would say, overall, we shall be closing to somewhere around 8 to 10K of exports this year, in the total financial year, FY2022. And moving ahead, we see, once our product reaches to that market, so we have a lot of customers who are asking us for the samples, plus we are now moving ahead with the 60 hertz as well. So we will be able to add our product reach to this Middle East sector as well. So we expect like 30 to 40% of the growth in next 3 years for this export market for Middle East.
Understood. And when we're competing in the Middle East market, how is our competitiveness versus, say, Thailand and China? Are we able to compete reasonably well on the cost side and the design factor that's required in these markets?
So, sir, if you see more or less like today, the value addition in India in terms of components, we make everything including motors and PCBAs. So our dependency lies majorly primarily on the compressor part only, right? Now the compressor part for the China or the Thailand market is also outsourced. Thailand does not make any compressors, so even it's outsourced for them. So more or less we are competitive. In fact, I would say the trade advantage better lies with other countries rather than from China. So what we have seen is that, so there is a disability of maybe 2-3% in terms of FOB prices, but with the freight coming into picture, so we are like set off against China.
Understood. And US market, we are expecting FY23 for the approvals and some export to pick up, right? Basically, FY next 60.
So, sir, US market is a bit different. You see, in the Middle East, the challenge was to get the certifications, while in the product that sells in India, more or less with a small tweaking, we were able to extend it to the Middle East market. While US is a totally a different story where we need to come up with a new product lineup. So, right now, we are in the designing phase. With the customer inputs, we are able to come up till, I will say, to the mock-up stages. So, next 1 year, we'll go in terms of making the final tooled samples. Then next year we'll take up into the approval. So we expect that by 23, we should be in position of sending initial lots of maybe 1,000, 2,000 quantities.
Okay. And just one last question. So the US market, for many products that we hear of, the duties that US is imposing on Chinese imports is quite high. Is that like a similar duty advantage that India would have because of the US-China trade war on AC imports from China into US?
So right now, the target segment that we are focusing is primarily the high voltage unit. So that has the same duty structure in, from China as well as India. So it has same duty structure. So the products, okay. Maybe you are referring to our commercial products and heat pumps. But room air conditioners have similar duty structure.
Okay. Thank you so much for that.
Right.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pritesh Chheda from Lucky Investments. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir, just two clarifications. So out of the India, whatever 5.5-6 million, whatever is the volume, is it fair to assume that 70% of that is outsourced and within that 50% is what we address?
No. So this number used to be 34% when we got listed. Now it has almost 45% industry is outsourced. Out of that 45%, we are doing 70%.
Okay, so out of 50%, you're doing 70%. Okay. This is as on, let's say, last year, FY21 or whatever, FY22, at 5.5-6 million volume.
That's right.
Okay, my second question is, we talk about the component landscape. So since half of the volume is, any case, outsourced, so I'm assuming that some of these basic components like heat exchanger, copper tubes, all of these would ideally be manufactured in India. Is it fair to assume that what is a bigger opportunity is basically the motors and the, what you do in Elgin and Ever, which is basically PCB circuits? So if you combine these 3-4 products, what is the opportunity available for outsourcing? And I'm assuming that a lot of it is imported today. So for these 3-4 main components, what would be the size of the pie?
Well, on the motor front, almost about 70% of the motors were being imported as of last year. Electronics, almost 67% was getting imported. And heat exchangers and sheet metal were not getting imported. They were getting outsourced within India.
Yes.
Like we supply heat exchangers to many customers and we supply sheet metal to many customers, injection molding to many customers.
Yes.
And cross flow fan is something which 60% of cross flow fan is getting imported. Plus the copper, aluminium and compressor part of it. You know, so we are into 6 categories of custom components. So we are giving solutions in sheet metal, injection molding, inverter PCB boards, motors, now starting into cross flow fans. And
perfect, I know that, sir. So now this electronics, motors, and cross flow fan, what should be as a per unit of AC?
This will be approximately close to about 4,000 rupees for an air conditioner.
Okay. In which almost 60-70% is imported, basically.
That's right. Yeah.
And other than us, who would be the player in this three categories?
All three categories have different competition. In motors, we have Nidec, which is a Japanese company. And we have a US-based company called Regal Beloit under the brand name Marathon, which was earlier GE Motors. These are the two companies competing with us. In PCB boards, we have a Japanese maker, Diamond, and then we have Indian manufacturer, MKM. Then we have a Chinese company, Magmeet, and there is a Korean company also. So four competition in that space. And in crossflow fan, 60% is getting imported. The little, lower version is basically the injection molding companies like PR and one more company.
So what I can understand is a 1600 crore odd opportunity which is still imported. How much of it should ideally flow to us?
No, first of all, you know, 1600 crore opportunity of this will convert into last year sales. Now let us see the number which is coming in 5 to 6 years from now. So, you know, at a CAGR of 15 to 16% of the industry, as per the Boston Consulting Group report and Frost and Sullivan report, industry will hit a number of almost about 24 million in next 8 to 9 years time. So if we compare that, and there will be, at that economies of scale, at least 10 million mark will be exporting from India. So we are talking about 35 to 40 million air conditioners getting produced in India in next 8 or 9 years time. Now, if we talk about that, the number comes out to be very big numbers.
Okay. I'll take that. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Neera Vasa from Anand Rathi. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir, and thank you very much for the opportunity. So I just had one clarification on the CAPEX number that you shared. So 350 crores of CAPEX is for 22 and 23 both or for 1 year?
So basically, Nirav, as we declared last year after we completed our QAP that we are coming up with greenfield facilities. So both the new greenfield facilities are getting, to a production start level within this year. Majority of the investments will go this year. So 300 crore is going into the two plants there, and plus the R&D capex and the subsidiary capex. So 350 odd crore will be invested in this year. Then next year will be another portion which is close to about 100 odd crore will be remaining.
Thank you, sir.
Question is answered?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Hitesh Tong from ICICI Direct. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity, sir. Sir, my question pertains to the new customer additions which had happened during this lockdown. I just wanted to know what kind of incremental volume are we going to generate out of this four customer which are already with us for ODM work. So what would be the incremental volume from those four customers, sir?
Hitesh, we expect to bring in additional 800,000 numbers of volume by next financial year because of these new customer additions.
Thanks, sir. And sir, my second question, this from the Elgin and Everfront, this new five customer which you have added, this five new customer are those same customer which we had which came for the refilling purpose, or these are the apart from this?
No, they are very different customers. There are existing customers in Amber who were earlier buying inverter PCB boards from China and other countries. So since we developed these products about 18 months back, and then this is the most critical functional component of air conditioner in almost parallel to compressor. So if inverter PCB board doesn't function, you will not be able to save your energy and the product will not even start. So, and no product, no brand gives us approval without conducting a proper validation assessments. And the validation assessment periods are as long as 18 months to 24 months. Depending on customer to customer. So with these five customers, we have already crossed that stage and we have come to a mass production level. Few more are in addition right now as we speak. So I think by next financial year, those customers will also be completing their validation assessment and then start.
Okay, great. And sir, my other question from the export point of view, you said like, you know, US, there's some client who is in approval, is under the approval process from the US. So can we get some idea what kind of, you know, revenue potential, not 1 year, 2 year, I know that is a kind of, you know, the future one, but some qualitative work, what would be the, you know, size in terms of, you know, that client to get work done from our.
You see, US is importing close to 19 to 20 million air conditioners annually, and largely from China and Thailand. So China is contributing around 75%, 25% is being catered from Thailand. And India is trying to pitch in, we at India from India is trying to pitch in into that category for the products. Yes, you know, there are four milestones to travel in export markets. The first one is the product availability. Second one is to get the regulatory clearance, because this is product which is regulated by Bureau of Energy Efficiencies of each and every country. Then third is to get the foot in the door, you know, and the fourth is to increase the share of business. So like Sachin appraised that, you know, with the Middle East, we have already crossed two milestones. Now we have come to third one. In US markets, we are at the first one. So the first one and the second one should be crossed by next year, and then we should see some volumes coming up. That's the reason why from last year, since we started our exports commentary, we've maintained that this is a mid to long-term strategy. So we should see somewhere about 3 to 5 years time export contributing a decent amount in the balance sheet.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. That's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Prashant Kutty from Sundaram Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. So just one clarification. I think I must have missed it. So did you share what is the market share we have at this point of time? And how has it been versus the last quarter?
Well, we're maintaining our market share of almost about 24% as we in this quarter.
Which is very similar to the last quarter as well?
I think a little better than the last. Last it was about 22% or something like that. This year it is 24%. So not a very big change.
Okay. And sir, given the fact that we're going to be seeing actually a lot of other players are also kind of adding up capacities on that front, in that sense, do we have any worry on that front? Because incrementally, how are we trying to kind of keep a check on that? Because the fact being that while the component side of the business will keep improving on the back of PLI and we'll probably keep getting autos over there, but on the actual AC side of it, how do we kind of tend to hold on to those market shares, at least improve upon that? Is there a scope for that, given that there are a lot of other capacities coming in as well?
Well, capacities which are coming is in the OEM category. We are into ODM category. So practically, they are not competing with us because we are not people who actually take the OEM jobs. This is the only first time we have taken the gas charging part because, the notification came just at the cusp of the season. So at such a short notice, you can't build up new tools and you cannot even shift existing tools from other countries. That's the reason why we opted this two-way strategy. But other than that, in ODM categories, we don't see any big R&D capabilities being built up. So assembly lines are getting added where we don't think so that it should impact our market share.
But at an industry level, from an outsourcing standpoint, like you highlighted, about 45-50% is outsourced. How much of that would be ODM? How much of that would be OEM at this point of time?
Well, we at Amber, we are about 97% ODM now.
Okay, and only you would be ODM. The others all would be OEM.
No, there are other companies also, ED Rubble, who's another ODM player with us, but they are not that backward integrated as we are, like 15 plants in India, and their product portfolio is not as strong. No other company has motors and inverter PCB boards developed by their own fronts. So that there are many reasons why we become first stop shop for the customer.
And one last question, sir. So right now you said that it's about 40 to 45 to 50%. As this kind of as the year ends, will that number keep increasing? Because you said that you'll probably end with a 6 million number. And if I assume a 50% of that number, and on that 50% you do about a 70% kind of a outsourcing on your own, that technically means about close to a 30% plus market share. So just understanding what would be the calculation going wrong over here.
Well, I can't comment on how what holds for future, but I can give you a brief history of outsourcing trend. The whole outsourcing trend started about 15-16 years back, and it was earlier 5%, then it came to 10%. It was hovering around 16% for many years, and then it jumped to 30%. So asset-light strategy is getting very popular between the brands. And they are very focusing on the core competencies of their own branding and sports service sales and other things. So when we got listed, this was 34%. Now it is 45%. As per Frost report, which was released 3 years back, they had predicted a number of 52% by 2023. So I don't know how it will shape up, but yes, outsourcing as a trend is evolving, not only in this sector, but we see it in other sectors also, in TV, in washing machines and other parts, even out of consumer durable market also. And we've strengthened our R&D capabilities looking into the same trend. We expect that it will go up, but what will be the number, it is very difficult to predict right now.
Sure. All the very best to you, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
The question is answered?
Yeah, it's done. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Rahul Soni from Smiths Limited. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, thanks for taking my question. Sir, our current capacity is around 5 million units for RAC. So going forward, post the commencement of a new plant, what will be our capacity for RAC manufacturing?
Rahul, we had almost about 4.5 million capacities earlier. And now since two facilities are getting added, we are adding to almost 2 million more. So it will be about 6.5 to 7.
By FY23?
By end of FY23.
Okay. And my second question is in on your volume and realization side. So since you are considering one IDU and one ODU as separate units, so when you report your volumes, so is it a mix of 50-50 between IDU, ODU, or this mix varies?
No, this mix keeps on varying because some of the customers are only buying IDUs from us, some are buying complete units and some are buying only ODUs from us. So this mix keep on varying. That's why from beginning we have maintained only in terms of units.
Okay. So if we, if I want to have an idea of what is your realization for IDU and ODU separately, what it is?
Oh, it'll keep on varying because, you know, within IDU we have more than 70 SKUs. So from 0.75 ton to 2 ton, it varies. But we sell IDUs worth 4,000 rupees and we sell it for 7,000 rupees also. So it completely varies.
Okay. And sir, like you said before that the increase in realization was due to the higher portion of premium AC. So have you seen actual growth in the demand for premium AC or it is due to the decline in overall volume?
No, it's basically industry is moving towards inverterization. Already 50% industry was inverter, and now with the new BE table change, I think 80% of industry will be 80 to 85% will get into an inverter basis, which is a very premium product.
Okay. So what's your percentage in inverter currently?
We are moving as per industry trend. So almost about 60% is inverter.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pulkit Patil from Goldman Sachs. Please go ahead.
Sir, thank you for taking my questions. So my first question is in line with one of the previous participants, that when you have these conversations with your customers, because many of those customers have a pretty high degree of reliance on you today, with 40-50% of their product being manufactured by Amber, is there a concern amongst them of having very high dependence on just one third-party manufacturer? So, I mean, that is something that does come up in a lot of our conversations. So it would be good to get your view on how your customers are thinking about, having significant reliance on one third-party manufacturer.
Well, I mean, we haven't seen that kind of conversations with our customers, but I would say that, if our customers look at Apple model, so Apple has been relying on Foxconn to a large extent, and they have only two or three worldwide suppliers consolidating into that. And that is what, our customers are also tending to be. Yes, did some of the customers, they did try bringing in other competitors as well, but none of there was not a very big success because of many reasons, because this is a product which requires a lot of R&D, and the geographical expansion presence in pan India in different locations in the customer clusters plus backward integration, we have done that over a period of 2 decades. So matching apple to apple comparison with Amber's profile, it can't be done overnight. I mean, it's not rocket science, but certainly it can be done, but it will take time if somebody has to do it. So, but yes, we feel that even the customer who's been relying more on us, they are growing our business. So that means it's a positive sign for us.
Sure, sir. So my second question is, have your conversations with your customer changed a little bit after the PLI on assembly has not come out? Any views on how that could progress? Because some of your customers were talking about doing more insourcing if the PLI would have come on the assembly part as well.
We are not talking about finished goods because that has not been covered under PLI. In the component side, yes, every industry is excited because this is after so many 3 or 4 decades, we are actually looking, green shoots are now visible, and we are looking for a good landscape change on the component ecosystem in the country for room AC sector. So I believe that after 3 or 4 years from now, copper, aluminium, compressors, motors, and all these PCBs will be 100% getting manufactured here in India, which is very positive for the whole industry. So that is what we discuss with our customers also.
Sure, sir. That's it from my side. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, due to the time constraint, this was the last question for today. I would now like to hand the conference over to Mr. Jasbir Singh from Amber Enterprises for closing comments.
Thank you. So with the growth opportunities we foresee on the domestic and export front, along with the government support, we believe we are very well positioned to capitalize on this opportunity. Thank you everyone for joining us. I hope we have been able to answer all your queries. In case you require any further details, you may please contact us or our investor relations advisors, Strategic Growth Advisors, HE. Thank you very much. Have a nice day ahead.
Thank you. On behalf of Amber Enterprises Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.